said the talks had been going on for several months, and the programme of Anglo-Irish studies had also been stepped up. Mr. Molyneux made his claims after being asked about a report in the Belfast newsletter this morning. And Dr. Fitzgerald was hinting at the move in a paper to be presented to the New Ireland Forum. He said he thought it would be a welcome step as long as the Dublin government accepted that it didn't give them any right to meddle in Northern Ireland affairs. He said he thought the government in the South now recognised they had lost out economically by isolating themselves from what he called the natural unit of the British Isles.
Referring to James Molyneux's contention. You were there, no?
Well, I was around, yes. In fact, I worked for much of my career on efforts to bring peace to Northern Ireland. I was involved, as Ruth kindly noted. But it seems to me that the key thing in relation to Northern Ireland was, from the point of view of the unions, was what we appear to have a claim in Articles 2 and 3 of the Constitution. We've removed that now. We have the very warm relations, I would say, and a whole lot of structure set up by the Good Friday Agreement. And I have in front of me the photograph on the front page of the Irish Times of Ian Paisley warmly greeting Bertie Ahern. And I think that is at the side of the Battle of the Boyne. I think that is the most important symbolic thing which sort of ends, I would think and hope, the suspicious approach of unions. And I don't think the common, which, like, if we go to the third thing, which rules
the network of the network of new friends.
Well, I can see the argument, and I don't want to play it down, but it seems to me that there would be still a residual emotional problem for many people in Ireland, which makes it unwise to push the issue now. We were always too close. The Anglo-Irish relationship was too long, too turbulent, and too intense psychologically. It is very different from that of the other dominions. And granted that membership of the Commonwealth was a contested issue for so long, the 20s and 30s, and after all, it was, in a sense, the Civil War was fought on that issue. It seems to me better now not to try to rewind the clock, so to speak, and go back to the Commonwealth when we have the warm relationship we have with Britain in the EU. And Ruth makes the point that we've been meeting other countries of
idea for being adopted, which has now been rejected by the Malawian authorities. So, you agree with what Pap says?
I absolutely agree.
Our sensitivities are irrelevant on what I was saying earlier on does not cut mustard that, we should be concerned about the white pop star parachuting and plucking out a child when, in fact, it might be better if they try to improve the circumstances of the region rather than just one child.
Well, I mean, if Madonna had originally intended on trying to adopt Mercy a number of years ago, it's not as though she just parachuted in and went eeny, meeny, miny, moe and picked a child. You know, this is media hype. She's obviously been trying to do this for a long time. It's just now spiraled into a media circus. And if you're in a position that you can give a child the quality of life and a chance at life that they have where they are, there's hardly the social services network set up in Malawi that a child would have maybe over in Europe. So if this child gets a chance of having a life, then why not? Who cares whether it's Madonna or somebody else? It's a single white female or married person.
I agree with you entirely. It's not that it's Madonna, because I've said already that I believe that this woman is a good mother. She has strong Catholic Italian leanings towards maternal responsibilities. Her instincts her credentials are impeccable from that point of view. Nobody would suggest for a moment that she will not make a good woman. She will make a good woman. I think the question is this the correct and the appropriate way to go about solving the problems of these regions or countries like Malawi? That's the question. Is this way you should do it?
Well, she's not a UN agent. She's just a person who is in a position to help a child and wants to do it. Just because you want to help one child doesn't mean you can't do it because you're not able to.